हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू आवर चैनल। दिस इज़ कविता शेट्टी एंड आई एम बैक विथ वन मोर वीडियो विच इज़ ऑन सीटेट नोटिफिकेशन 2021। एज यू नो, सीटेट ऑनलाइन एप्लीकेशन प्रोसेस हैव बीन स्टार्टेड एंड आई होप मेनी ऑफ यू हैव फिल्ड द फॉर्म्स एज वेल। इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर विथ यू सम ऑफ द चेंजेस इन सीटेट syllabus. Rather than changes, I would say there are some addition in the syllabus of CTET that should be noted down. I would say 70% of the syllabus would be same and 30% are the addition in the syllabus. Let us glance through the important information for CTET, which is going to be conducted on December 2021. As you can see, submission of online application through CTET website www.ctet.nic.in has been started from Monday itself, that is 28th September, and the last date for the submission of application form will be 19th October, which is on Tuesday, and the last date for submission of fee through e-chalan or debit or credit card will be 28th of October, which is Wednesday, and before 3:30 PM. Also, the final verification of payment of the fee by the bank will be done by 21st October, which is on Thursday. Online corrections, if any, if you feel in the particulars uploaded by the candidate, can be done by 22nd of October, that is on Friday, to 28th of October, that is on Thursday, and after that no corrections will be allowed. You can download admit card by the first week of December itself. This is tentative, and the dates of examination will be somewhere between 16th December to 13th of January. Exact date and shift of examination will be mentioned on your admit card itself. Declaration of result will be tentatively by 15th of February. Okay, so I hope you have downloaded the information bulletin. If not, you can download from the official website of CTET. Otherwise, I have provided the link for information bulletin PDF download in the description box itself. Paper 1 will start at 9:30 AM and will conclude by 12 noon, but you have to be in the examination center by 7:30. This is what they have given here, because the test will be computer based test and there will be checking of admit cards and computer, and after 9:30 nobody will be allowed in the examination center. For paper 2, the test will start at 2:30 PM and will conclude by 5 PM, but you have to be at the examination center by 12:30 PM. Again, there will be checking of admit cards and computer. Candidates will be permitted to enter the examination center after the commencement of the examination as per the time schedule given above or in your admit card. Now let us see the application fee for CTET December 2021 according to the category. General or OBC have to pay Rs. 1000 for only paper 1 or paper 2, whereas SC/ST or differently abled person have to pay Rs. 500. For both paper 1 and paper 2, general or OBC category, people have to pay Rs. 1200, while SC/ST differently abled person have to pay Rs. 600. Now let us see the structure and content of CTET. As usual, there will be MCQs with 4 alternatives, out of which one answer will be correct, or we can say most appropriate. Each MCQ will carry 1 mark and there will be no negative marking. Okay, as we know, CTET has paper 1 and paper 2. Those who want to become teacher for primary level, that is for classes 1st to 5th, they have to give paper 1. Those who wish to become teacher for elementary level, that is for classes 6 to 8, they have to give paper 2. Anyways, a candidate can attend both paper 1 and paper 2. Each paper will be of 2.5 hours. Okay, there is no change in the timings. Let us glance through paper 1. So first is CDP, that is Child Development and Pedagogy. There will be 30 MCQs for 30 marks. Second is Language 1,
which is of 30 MCQs. Again, language 2 of 30 MCQs. Maths of 30 MCQs. EVS of 30 MCQs. So there will be in total 150 MCQs for 150 marks.
Again, for paper 2, there are 4 subjects. One is CDP, second is language 1, third is language 2, fourth is maths and science or social science. You can select one of these subjects. CDP, language 1, language 2 are of 30 MCQs each, whereas maths and science or social science have 60 MCQs. The distribution is like 30 MCQs for mathematics and 30 MCQs for science for those who are taking up maths and science, and for social science it is 60 MCQs. So there will be total 150 MCQs for 150 marks. I would like to inform you one more thing, that paper will be bilingual, that is, you can view the questions in computer-based test either in English or Hindi. You can select languages from 20 languages for language 1 and language 2. So let us see the nature and standard of questions. The test items for CDP will focus on educational pedagogy, teaching and learning relevant to age group of 6 to 11 years, because we are dealing here with classes 1st to 5th. Also, the test items in language 1 will focus on the proficiencies related to the medium of instruction. And the test items in language 2 will focus on elements of language, communication and comprehension abilities. Means unseen passages will be included. Okay. Opt two languages in which you wish to appear for CTET, and list of languages and code are as follows. So as I told you, there will be 20 languages, out of which you can select one for language 1 and one more for language 2. So respective languages and code numbers are given. And for maths and EVS, we can see there are 30 MCQs for each of these subjects, out of which 15 will be numerical for maths and 15 will be based on pedagogy of maths. Similarly, for EVS, 15 will be on the topic and 15 will be on the pedagogy. And as the test is computer based test, so this test will focus more on the concepts and problem solving abilities, understanding and application of the subjects. And the items are distributed over different divisions of the syllabus. So you can refer the NCERT textbooks prescribed for classes 1st to 5th. Also, the difficulty level of paper 1 will slightly less than the difficulty level of paper 2. We have some elements added in language 1 and language 2 according to, as we say, new syllabus. We'll see in details as soon as we proceed this video. The questions in the test for paper 1 will be based on the topics prescribed in the syllabus of NCERT for classes 1st to 5th, but their difficulty standard as well as linkages could be up to the secondary stage. This is what we need to note here. Before we go to paper 2, let me tell you, our upcoming video will be based on computer-based test. I will provide you complete information on how you can log in to the link and give the test. I will also provide you some information regarding the centers of examination for mock test. So let us move towards paper 2, which is for secondary stage. Again, we can see there are subjects CDP, language 1, language 2, maths and science or social studies or social science. You can go for mathematics and science, those who want to become teacher for the same. Also, the test items on CDP, that is child development and pedagogy, will focus on educational psychology of teaching and learning relevant to the age group of 11 to 14 years, because here we are dealing with secondary stage, that is 6 to 8 standard. They will focus on understanding the characteristics, needs and psychology of diverse learners, interaction with learners and the attributes and qualities of a good facilitator of learning. Now, the language one will focus on proficiencies related to the medium of instruction. The test items in language two will focus on the elements of language communication and comprehension abilities. Again, there will be 20 languages, out of which one language you can select as language one and another language for language two. The available options as given, you can see English, Hindi, Assamese, Bengali, Garo, Gujarati, Kannada, Khasi, Malayalam, Manipuri, Marathi, Mizo, Nepali, Oriya, Punjabi, Sanskrit, Tamil, Telugu, Tibetan, Urdu. Respective code numbers are also given. You can see the test items in mathematics and science, or we can say social studies or social science, will focus on more on concepts, problem solving abilities and pedagogical understanding. As we know, maths and science will be of 30 marks each, and the test items will be from NCERT test book. Now let us see the syllabus in detail for paper 1, that is first subject, that is CDP, child development and pedagogy. There are 3 points. First is child development, that is for primary school child. The points are same except for the last point, which is formulating appropriate questions for assessing readiness level of learners, for enhancing learning and critical thinking in the classroom, and for assessing learner achievement. This point is added to the syllabus. If we move to the next subtopic, that is concept of inclusive education and understanding children with special needs. So we have the syllabus same for this subtopic, and for the subtopic C, that is learning and pedagogy, again we have the same points, there are no changes. So for child development, that is subtopic A, there are 15 questions. For topic B, there are 5 questions, and for topic C, there are 10 questions. So in all, there are 30 questions for CDP, as we can see. And the important point that I told you is in subtopic A, which is child development, the point or the addition in the syllabus is the last point, that is formulating appropriate questions for assessing readiness levels of learners. So there will be some tricky questions. Now let us move towards language 1. The change, or we can say the major change in syllabus, is in the language 1 part. Here you can see topic A is language comprehension, reading unseen passages, 2 passages, 1 prose or drama and 1 poem with questions on comprehension. Here the addition is the grammar part. Grammar, inference and verbal ability is what? Somewhat new for us. There used to be some grammar questions, but it was like 1 or 2, but here we can see main focus is done for inference, grammar and verbal ability separately. So prose passage here may be literary, scientific, narrative or discursive. Next is topic B, which is pedagogy of language development. Here the points included in the syllabus are almost same as the previous one. There is no such change that I can tell you. 15 MCQs each for A and B. This way we have 30 questions for language 1. Let us see for language 2. Again we can see here comprehension. There will be questions on grammar and verbal ability. This is what added to the syllabus. And B, subtopic is pedagogy of language development. So A, comprehension, and B, pedagogy of language development has 15 questions each. So in all there are 30 questions. Next we can see for mathematics. There is no change in the syllabus of mathematics. This goes with EVS also. The syllabus for EVS is same. Only you need to refer is NCERT textbooks for standard 1st to 5th, okay. Only thing we have to note down is 15 questions will be from content and 15 from pedagogical issues for both maths and EVS. Let us see for paper 2, that is for classes 6 to 8. For CDP, the syllabus is same except for the last point, as I told you for paper 1, that is formulating appropriate questions for assessing readiness levels of learners for enhancing learning. Okay, B subtopic, C learning and pedagogy all are same. and question distribution also given. Again, for language 1, the grammar part, inference and verbal activity, these elements are added. Same for language 2, grammar and verbal activity added. The syllabus for mathematics and science, also for social studies or social science, there is no change. For maths, 20 will be from content and 10 questions from pedagogy. Now for social studies, there will be 40 MCQs from content, which will consist of questions from history, then we have geography, then social and political life, and the rest 20 questions from pedagogical issues. I hope you understood the changes in the syllabus. For detailed syllabus, especially for the content part, you can refer NCERT textbooks for classes 1 to 8. Thanks for watching this video. I hope this video was helpful. If you like this video, then please share and please do subscribe our channel. Thank you.